The Airbus A380 is simultaneously a miraculous airliner and an absolute dud. It's certainly impressive. As the world's largest commercial jet, it carries over 500 passengers with ease in a unique double-decker configuration. But at the same time, most airlines that own the jet have bemoaned its unreliability and suspect operating economics. However, there is one airline that has become synonymous with the A380 and has consistently sung its praises. That airline is Emirates, the flag carrier for a small Middle East country that's seen a meteoric rise to become a global juggernaut. It is by far and away the largest operator of the A380, and it's widely believed that it's the only airline to consistently turn a profit using the jet. But what exactly is Emirates doing differently that ensures that its A380s are an asset rather than a liability? Let me explain. In trying to understand how Emirates is able to turn a profit using their A380s, we first ought to consider how Emirates has become the behemoth that it is today. In short, it is all about location. The Emirates hub at Dubai International Airport sits right smack dab between Europe and both Southeast Asia and Australia, regions of the world that are highly populous and economically interlinked. As a result, demand for air travel between these destinations is quite high. However, these regions are also quite far away from each other. When planes have to cover long distances, they obviously need to carry more fuel. But the added weight of this additional fuel makes the plane heavier and less efficient, necessitating even more fuel be loaded on board to cover the extended distance. When controlling for other variables, this means that fuel costs grow exponentially with distance. And more often than not, airlines pass these added costs onto their customers. By connecting through their hub, rather than flying these routes nonstop, Emirates is able to save a tremendous amount of money on fuel. Ultimately, this ensures that the airline can offer lower fares to their customers while only adding an hour or two to their trip. Because the location of its hub is advantageous, and since it can offer comparatively lower fares as a result, Emirates ends up handling a lot of the traffic between these regions. And it's widely understood that for most airlines, the A380 only turns a profit when it is at or near full capacity. So a reasonable assumption would be that the airline is able to achieve success with their A380s because they're almost always operated at full capacity. But this actually isn't the case. As a matter of fact, in 2019, Emirates saw a load factor of just 77%. In layman's terms, this means that any given Emirates flight was only 77% full on average. Comparatively, the average global load factor was 82% that same year. This fact adds a new wrinkle into the equation. Not only is Emirates able to turn a profit using their A380s, but they're also able to do so while filling a smaller percentage of their seats. So, in order to turn a profit, Emirates must be saving costs elsewhere. A reasonable place to turn to would be cost-cutting on their cabin product. But if you've ever flown Emirates, you'll know that this seems unlikely. While budget airlines will boost revenue by charging for things such as checked bags, entertainment, meals, and Wi-Fi, Emirates doesn't do any of that. Rather, it's been consistently ranked as one of the world's best airlines, receiving a 4-star rating from Skytrax in 2019. It also offers some of the most insane business and first-class products on the market, featuring full lie-flat seats in business and, in the case of first class, personal suites and showers. Needless to say, Emirates isn't nickeling and diming their passengers. So what exactly is the secret sauce that ensures Emirates can make their A380s profitable? Well, a recent interview with Emirates CEO Tim Clark might shed some light on this very subject. In November 2019, when asked about the stunning announcement that Air France would become the first airline to completely retire their A380 fleet, he said this: "The A380 was a misfit for Air France. They never scaled, they only ever had 10 aircraft. If you've got a 10, it's a bloody nightmare and the costs go through the roof. But if you've got 100 of them, your unit costs and operating with that number are a lot lower." Ultimately, what Mr. Clark is alluding to is that Emirates can profitably operate its A380s due to a concept known as economies of scale. Essentially, they are able to more efficiently operate their jets because they own so many of them. In fact, with 123 A380s ordered to date, Emirates owns nearly 50% of all A380s ever built. These savings likely started the moment that Emirates ordered its very first Super Jumbos. Emirates first placed an order for the A380 in 2007, when they agreed to acquire 55 of the jets from Airbus. Then, in 2013, Emirates ordered an additional 50. At a list price of $446 million per unit, the A380 is the most expensive commercial jet in the world. However, airlines often earn substantial discounts when ordering in bulk, since it helps to shore up the airplane manufacturer's backlog. And the bigger the order, the bigger the discounts. Considering Emirates is by far the world's largest A380 operator, and these two deals constituted the two largest A380 orders ever, it's likely the discounts on these orders were substantial. It's also highly likely that these discounts were significantly larger than those that other, smaller A380 operators received when ordering theirs. Once in operation, Emirates has continued to save on maintenance. Because they own so many of the type, the airline has built up its own in-house maintenance network for the A380, with mechanics that are better equipped to prioritize and streamline repairs. Other operators simply don't own enough of the type to make such an internal operation viable, and instead contract the maintenance out to third parties, which is generally more expensive. In addition, because they're the largest A380 operator, Emirates is better suited to negotiate on spare parts and can also order them in bulk, which further drives down repair costs. Finally, by having so many A380s, Emirates saves on crew training. They are able to train their pilots and cabin crews in larger batches and have greater flexibility on what routes they deploy their cabin crews on. Now, as I've talked about quite a bit on this channel, it's become the industry norm for airlines to move away from operating larger quad jets and towards operating smaller twin jets. They are simply more fuel efficient and more versatile on the routes that they can profitably serve. Emirates is not immune to this trend, as they have recently followed suit by placing orders for both the Boeing 787 and Airbus A350. But unlike other airlines, they have not accelerated the timeline for when their A380s will be phased out. Now, it's true that two A380s have already been withdrawn from the Emirates fleet. However, this is not because Emirates was dissatisfied with these planes, but rather because the airline maintains a policy of keeping a young fleet, letting go of any jets that reach 15 years of age. When you consider that Emirates is expected to receive its last A380 in 2021, and since the airline is pretty pleased with their A380 fleet, it's highly probable that they'll hold on to their last A380s until around 2040. If you guys have ever flown on an A380, whether it's for Emirates or another airline, tell me about it in the comment section below. I personally have never flown on one and would like to get a sense of your guys' opinions of the jet. And if enough people suggest it, maybe I'll even do an A380 flight review once all of this coronavirus mayhem settles down. And if you guys haven't seen it already, I will link this video's companion video on why Air France is retiring their entire A380 fleet somewhere right around here. And as always, if you learned something new today, leave a like and subscribe to keep learning. And until I see you again, don't forget to look up.